Dinosaurs may have been very big, but that didn't mean they could survive anything. Sometimes being big is not such a good idea. We know that dinosaurs ruled the earth for about 180 million years. Then around 66 million years ago, a huge rock about the size of a mountain from outer space called an asteroid smashed into the earth. The huge rock made lots of dust and dirt and rocks to fly up into the air. All the dust and dirt covered the planet and made the sky dark. The sun was blotted out. This made the earth very cold. When the light stopped, the plants died, leaving only their nuts and seeds to survive in the soil. The asteroid also made big waves in the sea and washed away most animals and plants nearby. There were many forest fires too. Then there were volcanoes that erupted. The plant-eating dinosaurs ran out of plants to eat, and then the dinosaurs that ate other dinosaurs ran out of food. Well, it is hard to know the real answer for mass extinction of the dinosaurs. Paleontologists still wonder whether it was because of the asteroid or the volcanoes, or both the asteroid and volcanoes. Did the animals get too cold or too hot? Did they run out of food? The recent studies have also opened up new possibilities about why the creatures became extinct. Dinosaur eggs were huge and needed longer incubation period and considerable resources to reach to adult size compared to other animals that survived the asteroid. Most of the dinosaurs died and became extinct along with other animals. An animal is extinct when it doesn't exist anymore anywhere in the world. But many other animals survived. Different types of insects, lizards, crocodiles, mammals, birds, sharks, fish, crabs, snails, flowers, ferns, and trees all made it through. Now the question is how? How did other animals survive? It could be because the animals were small and didn't need much food. Small mammals and snakes could live by eating beetles and other creatures that were protected in the soil. Maybe it was because they could eat the seeds the dead plants left behind, or mushrooms growing on the dead plants. Maybe it was because they could burrow into the ground to keep warm. Maybe it was because they could swim far away to keep safe. And maybe some of those dry seeds could grow into plants after they were buried for a long time. Meanwhile, in the sea, giant sea lizards died off. But crabs capable of eating almost anything were able to survive because they were not fussy. Lots of clams and snails with simple needs also survived. Only about 10% of the major groups of bony fish died out, but species from all six groups of turtles alive at the time and from most if not all groups of amphibians survived the impact. And as the plants grew bigger and stronger, big woolly mammoths, giant kangaroos and whales became bigger too. New types of plants grew like grass. And a long time later, human beings evolved. And that's us. Now mammals started ruling the earth. Now here comes the surprise. Dinosaurs didn't really die out. Some dinosaurs were small and had feathers, and these were the ancestors of birds that we see today. Most scientists now agree that birds are descended from dinosaurs whose arms were modified into wings and they simply flew away. Had the dinosaurs not been wiped out 66 million years ago, our species would probably never existed. Mass extinctions are the greatest murder mysteries ever known. Figuring out why some forms went extinct and others survived is no easy task, and even Sherlock Holmes would have struggled to solve the puzzles along with the paleontologist. The survival of some mammals is itself just one mystery, and scientists are still busily collecting evidence from the scene of the crime. Thanks for watching. Hope you liked it. Give it a thumbs up if you like it.